Welcome back. Well, the issue that we are discussing at hand is this bad, pathetic condition of roads in Ramamurthy Nagar. In fact, all you Bengalurians out there, if you are facing troubles in your locality, if you have such roads in your locality, please do tell us, share your views with News9. Call us on 0802236 0304 or 05, or you can even text us and tell us exactly what is the situation in your area on the numbers that are flashing on your screens. But coming back to exactly what happened, we spoke to Mr. Annamalai. He didn't give us many reassurances. In fact, he brought up more questions, Mr. Sunil.
I don't think even in 6 months this work is going to get completed. Absolutely. Because he had absolutely no idea. And in spite of that, he gave us a commitment saying that 6 months he'll complete the work.
Exactly. When we questioned him further about that, he didn't want to make any more promises after that. So it is, it's rather scary because God alone knows how long you'll have to stay in this kind of a condition. So that is something that you'll have to look into.
Children are suffering a lot.
No.
Because to
our Honorable Minister, Honorable Minister, letting him.
Yes, sir, Mr. Subramaniam.
Honorable Minister, Ramalingam Reddy is in charge of this work. Letting him inspect it. Let him take a decision about that. We want only 500 meters to be cleared.
Yes, sir, if you could hold the mic.
A small area which could be done very easily if this Karnataka government is not able to do it, is a shameful affair. But our Honorable Minister can do that, decide the issue, what to do. He has got certain powers. If he is able to get it done through this contract, let him do. Otherwise, through other contractors, let them also do that. Money is not a criteria for them because it is a Japan aid. What I feel, government sanction is not be there, will not be there. And the BWSU chairman himself is a cabinet rank minister. He has got certain powers that he can do, use his powers, or the minister use his power. See how best this handicap can be cleared. And we residents want to live happily. The road, at only we want road.
Definitely, there's absolutely no action being done. But we did speak to the corporator. Now we do have the MLA of the area, Mr. Baswaraj, connected as well. Mr. Baswaraj, we have several residents of Ramamurthy's Papamma layout here who have several woes when it comes to the roads. We do understand you have visited the area. What action can you take in this particular regard?
Hello?
Yes, Mr. Baswaraj, we are with the residents of Ramamurthy Nagar. So you have seen the condition of roads in this place, we understand.
Sir, yes, madam. We have coming. Hello?
Yeah. Yes, Mr. Baswaraj, go ahead.
3 months only. So I started the work in this here area. So now is rain is coming. So that's why roads are not.
Alright, Mr. Baswaraj, it's very simple. You have visited this area, you spoke to the residents, and you told them that the roads would get better. So why hasn't that been done?
Madam, yenagidindre male bartha ide ella kattigalanna kai gettkondidivi hangagi swalpa male ninte mele naavu ella vastigalanna drainages na madalike prayatnavan martivi.
Okay, Mr. Baswaraj, you're saying it rained, but this has been the situation for over a year. What happened in summer? In summer, what happened, Mr. Baswaraj? You had over a year's time.
Storm water?
No, Mr. Baswaraj. We are saying that it's been like this for over a year now. So what happened in the summer time when there were no rains?
Rain will be stopped. Then only we have to start the work. So,
Mr. Baswaraj, you had over 6 months' time. Mr. Baswaraj, it has been over a year now that they've been facing this problem. So you would definitely have had a time when there was no rain in between there. Bangalore doesn't rain all the time.
I am going today also. I taken the meeting to officers. So ivattu kuda adhikarigalu sabhe maadi ivattu kuda nanu helidene ivaga ಮಳೆ ಬರ್ತಾ ಇರೋದ್ರಿಂದ ನಾವು ಊರು ರಸ್ತೆಗಳಲ್ಲಿ ಮಾಡಿದ್ರೆ ಪ್ರಾಬ್ಲಮ್ ಆಗುತ್ತೆ ಮತ್ತೆ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಏನು ಸಮಸ್ಯೆ ಇದ್ರೂ ಕೂಡ ನಾನು ಸಾಲ್ವ್ ಮಾಡ್ತೀನಿ.
Mr. Baswaraj, we have the residents here who would like to ask a question to you. Go ahead, Mr. Pandit.
ಸರ್, 4 ದಿನದಿಂದ ಅವರು ಬಂದು ಕೆಲಸ ಮಾಡಿಲ್ಲ ಮತ್ತೆ ನೀವು ಅವತ್ತು ಬಂದು ನಮ್ಮ ಇವರು ಇಂಜಿನಿಯರ್ಸ್ ಆಗಲಿ ಲೇಬರ್ಸ್ ಆಗಲಿ
ಎಲ್ಲಿ
ರಾಮರ್ತಿ ನಗರ್ ಪಾಪಮ್ಮ ಲೇಔಟಲ್ಲಿ
ಏನು ಕೆಲಸ ಮಾಡಬೇಕು?
ಅದೇ ಸರ್, ಈಗ ಏನು ಮಾಡಿದ್ದಾರೆ, ಈಗ ಮನೆ ಹತ್ರ ಬಂದು ಪವರ್ ಕೇಬಲ್ ಕಟ್ ಮಾಡಿದ್ದಾರೆ.
ಏನ್ ಪವರ್ ಕೇಬಲ್?
ಮನೆ ಕೇಬಲ್ ಸರ್, ಮನೆ ಪವರ್ ಕೇಬಲ್ ಕಟ್ ಮಾಡಿದ್ದಾರೆ.
ಯಾಕೆ?
ಅದೇ ಅವ್ರು ಕೇಳಿದ್ರೆ ಜೆ ಸಿ ಬಿ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಸಿಕ್ಕಾಕೊಂಡು ಕಟ್ ಆಗಿದೆ ಅಂತ ಹೇಳಿದ್ರು. ಫಸ್ಟ್ ರೀಸನ್. ಸೆಕೆಂಡ್ ಥಿಂಗ್ ಬಂದು ಈಗ ನಮ್ಮ ಮನೆ ಒಳಗಡೆ ಹೋಗಕ್ಕೆ ಆಗ್ತಾ ಇಲ್ಲ, ಫುಲ್ಲು ಮಣ್ಣು ಹಾಕಿ ಇಟ್ಟಿದ್ದಾರೆ. ಕೇಳಿದ್ರೆ ನಾವು ಮಾಡ್ತೀವಿ, ಈಗ ಲೇಬರ್ಸ್ ಎಲ್ಲ ಊರಿಗೆ ಹೋಗಿದ್ದಾರೆ, ಬರ್ತಾರೆ ಅಂತ ಇದೇ ರೀಸನ್ ಹೇಳ್ತಾ ಇದ್ದಾರೆ.
ಜಸ್ಟ್ ಅ ಸೆಕೆಂಡ್ ಮಿಸ್ಟರ್ ಪಾಪಮಂಗು, ಬಿಫೋರ್ ವಿ ಗೋಯಿಂಗ್ ಟು ದಟ್, ಮಿಸ್ಟರ್ ಬಸವರಾಜ್
ಸರ್,
ಡು ಯು ನೋ ದ ಪ್ರಾಬ್ಲಮ್ ಇನ್ ಪಾಪಮ್ಮ ಲೇಔಟ್?
ಜಸ್ಟ್ ನೋ ಈ ಕಾಲ್ಡ್ ದಿಸ್ ಈ ಪಾಪಮ್ಮ ಲೇಔಟ್ ಟು ಎನಿ ರೆಸ್ಪಾನ್ಸ್ ಇಸ್ ನಾಟ್ ಕಾಲ್ಡ್ ಫಾರ್ ಮೀ. ಸೊ ಯಾರು ನನಗೆ ಫೋನ್ ಮಾಡಿ ಈ ತರ ಪಾಪಮ್ಮ ಲೇಔಟ್ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಈ ತರ ಪ್ರಾಬ್ಲಮ್ಸ್ ಇದೆ
ಇಲ್ಲ ಸರ್ ಪ್ರಾಬ್ಲಮ್ ಗೊತ್ತಾ ಪಾಪಮ್ಮ ಲೇಔಟ್
ಈ ಹೇಳಿದ್ರೆ ನಾನು ಇಮಿಡಿಯೇಟ್ಲಿ ಅಟೆಂಡ್ ಮಾಡ್.
Mr. Subramaniam, you've said you've spoken to him, so tell us exactly when you spoke to him.
ಮನೆಗೆ ನೀವು ಬಂದಿದ್ದೀರಾ?
Just a second, sir. So we have residents asking a query. Go ahead, ma'am.
Sir, ನಮ್ಮ ಮನೆಗೆ ಬಂದಿದ್ದೀರಾ ನೀವು ಪಾಪಮ್ಮ ಲೇಔಟ್ ಇದ್ದ?
ಹಾ, ಹೇಳಿಮ್ಮ.
ಪಾಪಮ್ಮ ಲೇಔಟ್ ನಾರಾಯಣ ಸ್ಕೂಲ್ ಆಪೋಸಿಟ್ ಮನೆ.
ಹಾ,
ಟೈಲ್ಸ್ ಎಲ್ಲ ಬಿದ್ದಿದೆ ಅಂತ ನೋಡಿದಿರಲ್ಲ ಸರ್?
ಅದೇ ಮಾ, ಇದು ಮೇನ್ ರೋಡ್ ಅಲ್ಲಿ.
ಹಾ, ಮೇನ್ ರೋಡ್ ಕರೆಕ್ಟ್. ಹಾ,
ಸ್ಕೂಲ್ ಆಪೋಸಿಟ್ ಅಲ್ಲಿ.
ಹಾ, ಕರೆಕ್ಟ್ ಸರ್.
ಬಂದು ಹೇಳಿದಿನಲ್ಲ ಮಾ, ಕೆಲಸ ಮಾಡ್ತಾವ್ರಲ್ಲ.
ಹಾ, ಇಲ್ಲ, ಇನ್ನು ಏನು ನಡೆದೇ ಇಲ್ಲ ಸರ್, ಹಂಗೆ ಇದೆ.
ಮಿಸ್ಟರ್ ಬಸವರಾಜ್, ನೀವು ಬರೋಗೆಲ್ಲ ಕೆಲಸ ನಡೆಯುತ್ತೆ, ನೀವು ಬಂದಿಲ್ಲ ಅಂದ್ರೆ ಕೆಲಸ ನಡೆಯಲ್ಲ. ಸೊ ದ ಮೂಮೆಂಟ್ ಯು ಆರ್ ದೇರ್ ದ ವರ್ಕ್ ಹ್ಯಾಪನ್ಸ್.
ಇಲ್ಲ, ಈಗ ಏನಾಗಿದೆ, ನಾನು ಇವತ್ತು ಕೂಡ ನಾನು ಸತೀಶ್ ಹತ್ರ ಮಾತಾಡಿದ್ದೀನಿ, ನಿಮಗೆ ನಾಳೆ ಬಂದು ಕೆಲಸ ಶುರು ಮಾಡ್ತೇನೆ.
ಬಸವರಾಜ್ ಸರ್, ಲಾಸ್ಟ್ ಮಂತ್ ನೀವು ಬಂದು ವಿಸಿಟ್ ಮಾಡಿದೀರ ಏರಿಯಾದಲ್ಲಿ ಸರ್, ನೀವು ಏರಿಯಾ ನೋಡಿದೀರ, ನೀವು ಅಲ್ಲೇ ಸ್ಪಾಟ್ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಇಂಜಿನಿಯರ್ಸ್ ಎಲ್ಲ ಕದ್ದು ಎಲ್ಲ ಇನ್ಸ್ಟ್ರಕ್ಷನ್ ಎಲ್ಲ ಕೊಟ್ರಿ, ಅಂಡ್ ಗಿವನ್ ನಿಮಗೆ ಡೆಡ್ ಲೈನ್ ಕೊಟ್ಟರು 31st July ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಕಂಪ್ಲೀಟ್ ಮಾಡ್ತೀವಿ ಅಂತ. ಬಟ್ ಈಗ ನಾವು ಆಲ್ರೆಡಿ ವಿ ಆರ್ ಇನ್ 18th August, ಇಲ್ಲಿ ತನಕ ಕೆಲಸ ನಡೆದಿಲ್ಲ. ಆಸ್ ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಕೆಲಸ ನೀವು ನೋಡಿದಾಗ ಹೆಂಗಿತ್ತು 1 month ಬ್ಯಾಕ್, ಇವಾಗಲೂ ಹಾಗೆ ಇದೆ ಸರ್.
ಸರ್, ಮಾತಾಡಿ, ನಾಳೆ ಬೆಳಿಗ್ಗೆ ನಾನು ಅಧಿಕಾರಿಗಳಲ್ಲಿ ಕಳ್ಸ್ಕೊಡ್ತೀನಿ ಸರ್.
ಓಕೆ, ಇಟ್ ಸೀಮ್ಸ್ ಲೈಕ್ ಮಿಸ್ಟರ್ ಬಸವರಾಜ್ ಡಸ್ಂಟ್ ನೋ ದ ಪ್ರಾಬ್ಲಮ್ ಅಟ್ ಹ್ಯಾಂಡ್. ಮಿಸ್ಟರ್ ಸುನೀಲ್, ಇಫ್ ಯು ಕುಡ್ ಎಕ್ಸ್ಪ್ಲೈನ್ ಟು ಹಿಮ್ ವಾಟ್ ಇಸ್ ದ ಪ್ರಾಬ್ಲಮ್ಸ್ ಯು ಫೇಸ್ ಯುವರ್ ಫಸ್ಟ್.
ಇನ್ಫ್ಯಾಕ್ಟ್ ಬಸವರಾಜ್ ಅವರೇ, ನೀವು ಬಂದು ನೋಡಿದ್ದೀರಾ ಮನೆಯಲ್ಲಿ, ಇನ್ಫ್ಯಾಕ್ಟ್ ಆ ಮನೆಯಲ್ಲೂ ನೋಡಿದ್ದೀರಾ, ಮನೆಯಿಂದ ಹೊರಗಡೆ ಬರಕ್ ಆಗ್ತಾ ಇಲ್ಲ. ಸೊ ಯು ನೋ ದ ಪ್ರಾಬ್ಲಮ್ಸ್. ಆದ್ರೆ ಇದು ಟೈಮ್ ಲೈನ್ ಕೊಟ್ಟಿದ್ದೀರಾ, ಆದ್ರೆ ನಥಿಂಗ್ ಇಸ್ ಹ್ಯಾಪನಿಂಗ್ ಫಾರ್ ಅಸ್. ವಿ ರೆಸಿಡೆಂಟ್ಸ್ ಆರ್ ಫೇಸಿಂಗ್ ಅ ಲಾಟ್ ಆಫ್ ಇಶ್ಯೂಸ್
ಅಂಡ್ ದ ಜೆಸಿಬಿ ಯು ಬೀಯಿಂಗ್ ಓವರ್ ದೇರ್.
ನಾವು ಮನೆಯಿಂದ ಹಾಫ್ ಸ್ಟಾಪ್ ಜಂಪ್ ಮಾಡ್ತಾ ಇದೀವಿ, ಸ್ಟ್ರೇಟ್ ಇಂಟು ದ ಸ್ಲಶ್. ನಾವು ಮನೆಯಿಂದ ಹೊರಗಡೆ ಬರಕ್ ಆಗ್ತಾ ಇಲ್ಲ. ಟೆಲ್ ಅಸ್ ಹೌ ಡು ವಿ ಸ್ಟೇ ಇನ್ ಅವರ್ ಹೌಸಸ್, ಹೌ ಡು ವಿ ಲಿವ್?
ಸರ್, ನಿಮ್ಮ ಕಲ್ಸಿ ಅದನ್ನ ನಾನು ಖಂಡಿತ ಮಾಡ್ಸ್ಕೊಡ್ತೀನಿ ನಮ್ಮ
ಮನೆಯಿಂದ ಗಾಡಿ ತೆಗಿಯಕ್ ಆಗ್ತಾ ಇಲ್ಲ. ಇನ್ಫ್ಯಾಕ್ಟ್ ನಾವು ಹೇಗೆ ಹೋಗೋದು ಆಫೀಸ್ಗೆ ಹೇಳಿ.
ನಾಳೆ ಎಕ್ಸಿಕ್ಯೂಟಿವ್ ಇಂಜಿನಿಯರ್ ಸತೀಶ್ ಅವರು ನಿಮ್ಮ ಮನೆ ಹತ್ರ ಬರ್ತಾರೆ, ಖಂಡಿತವಾಗಿ ಸಾಲ್ವ್ ಮಾಡ್ತಾರೆ.
ಸರ್, ಇದಕ್ಕೇನಾದ್ರು ಡೆಡ್ ಲೈನ್ ಒಂದು ಇದೆಯಾ ಸರ್, ಯಾವಾಗ ಕಂಪ್ಲೀಟ್ ಮಾಡ್ತಾರೆ ಅಂತ ಏನದು?
ಖಂಡಿತ ಮಾಡ್ತೀನಿ.
ಅಲ್ಲ ಅಲ್ಲ, ಇದಕ್ಕೇನ ಡೆಡ್ ಲೈನ್ ಕೊಡೋಕ್ಕಾಗತ್ತಾ ನೀವು? 1 month 2 month?
ಇಲ್ಲ, 1 month 2 month ಏನು ಬೇಡ, ಶಾರ್ಟ್ಲಿ ನಿಮ್ಗೆ ಫಿನಿಶ್ ಮಾಡ್ಕೊಡ್ತೀನಿ.
ಅಲ್ಲ ಸರ್, ಶಾರ್ಟ್ಲಿ ಅಂದರೆ ಒಂದು ಟೈಮ್ ಕಮಿಟ್ಮೆಂಟ್ ಕೊಡೋಕ್ಕಾಗತ್ತಾ ಅಂತ?
ಸರ್, ಈಗ ರಸ್ತೆ ಎಲ್ಲ ಮಾಡಕ್ಕೆ
ಹೋದಾಗ ನಿಮಗೆ ಏನಾಗುತ್ತೆ, ಮಳೆ ಬರ್ತಾ ಇದೆ. ಅಲ್ಲ ಸರ್, ನೋಡಿ, ನೀವು ಲಾಸ್ಟ್ ಟೈಮ್ ಕಮಿಟ್ಮೆಂಟ್ ಕೊಟ್ಟರೆ 31st July ಕಂಪ್ಲೀಟ್ ಆಗತ್ತೆ ಅಂತ.
ಸ್ವಲ್ಪ ಮಳೆ ನಿಲ್ಲಿ.
ಅಲ್ಲ, ಕರೆಕ್ಟ್. ನೀವು ನೋಡಿ, ಲಾಸ್ಟ್ ಟೈಮ್ ನೀವು ಹೇಳಿದ್ರೆ 31st July ಕಂಪ್ಲೀಟ್ ಆಗತ್ತೆ ಅಂತ. ಈಗ ಅದಾಗಿ 15 days ಆಯಿತು, ಇನ್ನೇನು ಕೆಲಸ ನಡೀತಾ ಇಲ್ಲ, ಅದಕ್ಕಾಗಿ ಕೇಳ್ತಾ ಇದ್ದೀವಿ.
ಮಿಸ್ಟರ್ ಬಸವರಾಜ್, can you promise that you will be there tomorrow to talk to these residents at Pappamma layout?
Tomorrow definitely I will talk.
But also, Mr. Bhaswaraj, you had visited this area earlier, you had spoken to Mr. Subramaniam. Mr. Subramaniam, if you could talk to him and tell him what he saw, what he promised you.
ಏನಾಗಿದೆ ಮೇಡಮ್, ನಾನು ಹೋಗಿದ್ದೀನಿ, ನೋಡಿದ್ದೀನಿ, ಎರಡ್ ಸರಿ.
ಇಲ್ಲ ಇಲ್ಲ, 1 ನಿಮಿಷ ಸರ್, 1 ನಿಮಿಷ.
ನನ್ನ ನಮ್ಮ ಆಫೀಸರ್ಸ್ ಎಲ್ಲ ಇನ್ಸ್ಟ್ರಕ್ಷನ್ಸ್ ಕೊಟ್ಟಿದ್ದೀನಿ. ಸೊ ಹಂಗಾಗಿ ಅವರು ಸ್ವಲ್ಪ ಕೆಲಸ ಏನಾಗಿದೆ, ಲೇಬರ್ಸ್ ನಾವು ಸ್ವಲ್ಪ ಪ್ರಾಬ್ಲಮ್ ಆಗಿದೆ ಅಂತ ಹೇಳಿ ಸ್ವಲ್ಪ ಇದು ಮಾಡಿದ್ದಾರೆ. ನಾನು ಖಂಡಿತ ಕೆಲಸ ಮಾಡ್ಕೊಡ್ತೀನಿ.
ಚಿಲ್ಡ್ರನ್ ಸ್ಕೂಲ್ಗೆ ಹೋಗೋ ಕಷ್ಟ ಇದೆ, ನೀವು ಮನಸ್ಸಿಟ್ಟರೆ ಎಲ್ಲ ಮಾಡಬಹುದು ಅಂತ ಎಷ್ಟೋ ಸಾರಿ ನಿಮ್ಮ ಹತ್ರ ಹೇಳಿ. ಅವ್ರು 30 ಸರ್ ರಾಕ್ ಬರ್ತದೆ ಸರ್, ನೀರು ಬರ್ತದೆ ಸರ್, ನೋ ಐ ಆಮ್ ನಾಟ್ ಇಂಟ್ರೆಸ್ಟ್ ಆಲ್ ದೋಸ್ ಥಿಂಗ್ಸ್. ಯು ಮಸ್ಟ್ ಫಿನಿಶ್ ವರ್ಕ್ 31st July ಟೈಮ್ ಕೊಟ್ಟರು ನೀವು, ಫಾರ್ ವಿಚ್ ಐ ಥ್ಯಾಂಕ್ ಯು ವೆರಿ ಮಚ್. ಬಟ್ ಅವ್ರು ಮಾಡಿಲ್ಲ, ಹೋಗಿ 5 ದಿವಸ ಮಳೆ ಇಲ್ಲ, ಮಳೆ ಇಲ್ಲ, ವರ್ಕೂ ಇಲ್ಲ. ಅವ್ರಿಗೆ ಏನು ಸರ್ ಹಾಲಿಡೇಸ್ ಅಲ್ಲ, ಗೌರ್ಮೆಂಟ್ ಹಾಲಿಡೇ ಮಾದರಿ ಪೂಜಾ ಹಾಲಿಡೇಗೆ
ತೋರಿಸಿಲ್ಲ,
ನಿನ್ನೆ ಬಂದಿಲ್ಲ, ಸಂಡೇ ಬರ ಏನು ಸರ್ ಕಾಂಟ್ರಾಕ್ಟ್ರ್ ಏನು ಸರ್ ಗೌರ್ಮೆಂಟ್ ಹಾಲಿಡೇ ಮಾದರಿ ಅವ್ರು ತೋರ್ತಾ ಇದ್ದಾರೆ. ನೋಬಡಿಸ್ ಆಸ್ಕಿಂಗ್, ನೋಬಡಿ ವಿಸಿಟಿಂಗ್, ಯಾರ ಬಂದು ಕೆಲಸ ಮಾಡ್ತಾರಾ ಇಲ್ಲಿಯಾ? ಅವ್ರು ಗೌರ್ಮೆಂಟ್ ಆಫೀಸರ್ ಬರೋಲ್ಲ, ಇವರು ಕಂಪನಿ ಆಫೀಸರ್ ಯಾರು ಬರೋಲ್ಲ. ಅವರು ಸುಮ್ಮನೆ 4 ದಿವಸ ಜೆ ಸಿ ಬಿ ಆದರೆ ಸರ್ ನಮ್ಗೆ ದುಡ್ಡು ಕೊಟ್ಟಿಲ್ಲ ಸರ್ ಅವರು ನಾ ಏನು ಮಾಡು ಸರ್ ರಿಪೇರ್ ಆಯಿತು ಸರ್ ಆ ಥರ ಅವನು ಹೇಳ್ತಾನೆ
ಸರ್ ಎಷ್ಟು ಟೈಮ್ ಸರ್
ಮೇಡಮ್ ಇನ್ನೊಂದು 15 ದಿವಸದಲ್ಲಿ ಫಿನಿಶ್ ಮಾಡ್ತೀನಿ ಮೇಡಮ್ ಮೇಡಮ್
ಸರ್ 15 ಡೇಸ್ ಇಟ್ ವಿಲ್ ಬಿ ಡನ್ 15 ಡೇಸ್ ರೋಡ್ ವಿಲ್ ಬಿ ಓಕೆ
ಯೆಸ್
So, sir, if you have seen the condition of the road, we spoke to the contractor, he said 6 months.
No, no, don't want 6 months. We will take another 15, 20 days. I will finish that work, so whatever is going on, sewage work. Definitely, I will do it.
Okay. All right, Mr. Vasu Raj. All right. So, you will come to tomorrow, you will talk to these residents and you assure them by the end of this month, everything will be done. All right, thank you so much for talking to NewsNet, Mr. Baswaraj. So there you have it. One person says 15 days, another person says 6 months. So where do you stand at the end of all of this is the question. This is the...
This is never ending.
I think we contacted that contractor is the wrong person because he is not aware of the what is the job going on the area. And who the actual person is supposed to take the responsibility, he is not coming at the project.
No, we
so we are not getting
media,
a proper information.
Something will be... That media, it is media to look after us.
No,
that,
but even then, when we spoke to the MLA, we've spoken to the contractor, we have the local corporator here, there is nobody else you can possibly go to after this.
Madam,
and
what,
with all of them promising different things.
Madam, that's what you say, the contractor who came on the line is not aware of this project, what is going on.
Hmm.
And corporator madam is busy with other work, they are saying, they are giving information that 15 days, I mean, job is complete, going to complete. Now you have seen the area, what is action plan in practical. Now, do you
in
think
practicalities, 15 days is impossible.
Anyone can agree that 15 days is possible to complete?
No.
Not possible. Even if you take another 2 months also, I don't think it will be completed.
Hmm.
And now the MLA, have been spoken to MLA. Now he is also, earlier also, last month also he came physically, twice he has been visited the place.
Hmm.
But he has been instructed the officers and they have given a commitment that 31st July is the last day to complete the job. Now we are in 18th of August, till nothing, no progress has been taken place. Even if it takes another 2-3 months, there is no doubt in that.
I can assure you that if this is done in 15 days, this will be the shortest delay by any construction
exactly.
work. That, because 31st, if they said 1 month, if they finish it, it will be perfect.
Exactly.
But Mrs. Tejaswini, did you ever speak to Mr. Baswaraj about this?
No, actually, I didn't talk to him.
Hmm.
What happened? No, that contractor has told you it is very difficult to do this sanitary work. But it is wrong. Because in our ward, 18.5 kilometers, our ward is too big ward.
Okay.
So Ramurthy Nagar is little bit CMC area.
Mm.
So other places are panchayat area.
Mm.
That is almost 14 villages will be there in our ward. So there some areas we only did some sanitary works.
Mm.
Within 15 days we did the sanitary works in one layout. So like that they can do, but here they are saying some problem is there. So that's why they are making delay, I think. So if they will take a little bit interest, definitely they will do early as possible.
Yes, Mr.
Madam, as the madam said rightly, that out of the 14 kilometers distance or they've been covered within 15 days or 20 days to complete the job. Our area is hardly not more than 500 meters. Why they want to take more than a year?
No, even then, you
what
said
are,
that...
What are the difficulties? What are the rock? What are the problems are there?
Mm.
Is it required more than 12 months?
Exactly. No, but now they are saying that they will finish it in 15 days. In fact, we have got the MLA lined up for you now. So he will come in tomorrow and you can talk to him. You'll get the contractor there as well. So will you get a definite time then is the question now.
That we need to wait and see tomorrow.
But Mr. Subramaniam, you said that you had spoken to the MLA. He had visited the place earlier on.
Yes.
When was that?
Huh?
When was that?
It is month of July 2nd
July
week.
First week or second week?
July 2nd week.
Okay, and then
but
he said
at that
July.
Time he gave 31st is the last day.
Okay.
July 31st.
But they agreed.
Yes, sir.
So
we will come.
He visited the project, he has seen the area and the first week of July. And he has been spoken to all the concerned government officers and they have given the commitment, as he said, the rock and all the problem explained. So MLA said nothing done, they have to complete the job. He has asked the deadline from the officials itself. So they have given the deadline of 31st July.
So did you, as soon as you spoke to the MLA, did you see a change? Was there any speedy work being done immediately?
One or about 2 days.
That's what, when the MLA has been spoken to the officers, for next 2-3 days, some work has been taken place in SPD. Afterwards, again, back to the pavilion.
And now again, he's saying month end, it will be
even
done.
Even if you, I want to add one more word saying that now we are not lost the main road. You see the area, a lot of good, trees have been grown. Even because of this project, we are losing all good trees also, grown trees, we have been losing it.
No, more than that, Mrs. Dani, you were telling me about how it wasn't just a problem of getting out of your house, but you have so many mosquitoes in the area as well. So your children must be prone to diseases also, but dengue on the rise in the city especially.
It's correct. Now, actually, my son is having fever. Frequently, he's getting fever because of this.
So you have checked up with the doctors and seen what it could
be? They say it's a viral fever.
But all of you as families must face a lot of issues when it comes to not just civic problems where you can't reach anything as such,
yeah,
but also
no milk for us, no newspapers, nothing we could get.
So how do you get
it's
your
like
basic
a house needs? Arrest, complete house arrest for us.
Without any
no sump water, no sump water, nothing.
So there is no water in your area, there is no basic, there's no milk, there's no newspaper, you're completely stranded.
In fact, before starting up this project, our area is called like a VIP road and a beautiful road actually.
It's ironic definitely because you don't even see a road now, so for vehicles to come in and out is completely...
And moreover, apart from our Papam layout road, all nearby the side road like Madam has said, everything has been now in good condition except our Papam layout area.
Why is that? Why have
because
they...
Because the contractor not taking seriously the job.
Okay.
They're just giving a then and there the excuses they're giving, they're delaying the work.
Okay, Mr. Bhage, why do you think it is that there's a delay in the work so far?
Delay, there is no doubt it
so
is
if you
a
could
rocky
talk
area
mic.
Below.
Huh.
And they are unable to cut and because it's a built area.
So if you could talk with the mic.
It's a built area both sides. Therefore, they cannot blast it so heavily. So this is one reason in their favor. But in our favor, we are unable to move. We are always sleeping here and there. There is a lot of ditches, big ditches on the bow, and our water tankers are unable to come, our vehicles are unable to come, our cars where they are standing, they are there only for long periods, and our school children are unable to go and come, and there is a lot of difficulty. We are thinking the time 80 years ago, when the entire India or the villages were like that.
Even the relatives to hesitate to come to our houses.
No, that is ironic because in your area, it's not just houses, very residential area. You also have schools, you also have shops, and all of this is completely out of access now. So have those authorities done anything to bring about some awareness to talk to people in the area?
You are our rescuers only.
Yes.
Yes.
You
so if you could
alone.
Hold the mic.
That
so.
Is, that you hold it.
You are alone. This your... media people have come. We are thankful to you. I hope you will continue our. You will
yes, support.
Give us support to get it done.
No, there is no question. We will definitely follow up. In fact, in 15 days' time, we will come and see what the scene is, if there is any work at all done. But I don't know how far that is possible because we have seen the length of damage in that particular road. Absolutely no tar, no concrete, even the sides are gone. So when it rains, how bad does it get?
It's very bad. We
bad
think we have when you are situated in city or we are in a village, we have a doubt.
People are like Himalaya, you know? They are scatting. They are not walking.
So it doesn't get completely flooded up because we saw that there's this huge gorge almost which goes in
it's
there.
Like
so
the moment it came outside in the rainy season, land will be like skidding.
Yeah, because there's so
even
much slush.
Can, I mean, driving in the two-wheelers also is risky.
So people must have, there must be so many people who got hurt during that time as well.
Exactly.
So any of your families or anything that faced a huge, in fact, crippled by these rains every time it came, every time you had a problem?
Hospital list we have to take. Because we cannot, sad dog, children
Mike,
are
Mike,
getting
Mike,
fever.
Mike, Mike.
And we are taking to hospitals. If this is normal course of action, even if the road is good, also doctor will go. But this because of road is worst. There's fever and other things, people are affected. And we are going, taking some treatment, coming away. That is, we want road to be cleared. That's all. Nothing else we want.
It's as simple as
simple,
that.
Simple person, 600 feet, another 300 feet. If they do, then thawing is could be done. So the MLA and I request our corporator to see, either the seriousness, let them put on this work, instead of themselves to be serious, their own, let them put,
it could be done. Our corporator can, he's a, but also a very good worker, social worker. She minds, she can do it, what I think. If she minds, she can do. Push the PWSSB people, push the officers, push the MLA and other things, everything could be done. We will give fullest cooperation. We residents will give fullest cooperation. We want things to be separate.
But Mrs. Tejas, only one basic question that we can't help but notice. Over a year, this problem has been there. You have been following it up personally. Now, as soon as you were voted into power, you must have realized that this was an issue. You are from the Congress, we understand. Now, Mr. Baswaraj, why haven't you ever spoken to him?
Actually, we are BJP.
Okay, you are from
so,
BJP.
Yeah. Not yet, we have this.
At the time of election, we gave her our Ashirwad to her. And soon after those people, these contracts people came, 1100 each though. I said, what is this corporate is telling, don't give anything. They say, she will send you notice. That they were talking on her behalf, that they will send you the notice. I said, we will meet her and remind her of our Ashirwad. She got elected.
No, but Mrs. Tejaswini, you're from the BJP. Mr. Baswaraj is also from the BJP.
No, Congress.
He's from the Congress. All right. So, but why haven't you spoken to him then?
Actually, I have BWSSP line. So, I usually talk to him itself because this is the problem of BWSSP. In BBMP, we have already this road sanctioned.
But the simple thing is, when a corporator in the area faces a problem, the immediate solution is to go to your higher up, which is your MLA. So how come you've never approached him?
Actually, I have with BWSP line. We are different parties.
So it is you have never met him personally?
Not yet, ma'am.
Okay, so over a year, and that is the problem possibly because there was a serious communication gap. So even Mr. Baswaraj, when we spoke to him earlier, he didn't know what we were talking about.
The Baswaraj came elected only recently now, madam, not earlier. The earlier BJP government only.
Yeah.
The earlier Mr. Nandesh Reddy, the MLA, the same BJP government, the Congress came only recently.
But he was completely unaware. When we told him, he was wondering what we were talking about. That is another shocking thing because you said he came just last month. So how many issues does he have to deal with is the question. But definitely, it is shocking. But we do have many Bengalurians calling in at this point. We have a Bengalurian calling in from Hennur Road. Please go ahead and tell us what your problem is.
There is no political problem. So only thing is that...
Somebody. Yes, Mr. Bala, go ahead. Well, we've got several callers coming in. In fact, it looks like Mrs. Paula wants to talk to us. Ms. Paula, go ahead.
Hennur Road. Hello.
Ms. Paula, welcome to News9. Tell us exactly what is the condition of the roads in your area.
No, we had Vivek here from your TV9 who had come here about 2 weeks back on a Monday. And he inspected the roads and also the dengue story. But I find there is no change at all. It is 2 weeks now. Nobody has reacted and nobody has done anything on our roads. What is the state today? When we went out, we almost went into a very deep ditch. And because of that, the under of the car had got scraped. Now, what is the condition? Are you all not going to help us by covering this on the media? Where is the chance of getting this done? Why are the corporators not working and waking up and doing something for us? What is happening?
Ms. Paula, where are you calling from?
I'm calling from Hennur Main Road.
All right. So we had one of our colleagues come and cover it for a reason. We wanted to bring it out. We promise we will take action in that particular regard. But thank you so much for calling in and explaining exactly what happened in your particular area. But this is exactly what we're seeing. So many places, so many different woes. In fact, we have been going on a sort of survey to find out different roads, and that was one of them, Hennur. So a lot of chaos coming in at this point. But in your particular regard, what is it that you want? Just good roads. That's all you want.
It's a basic necessity that we're looking at, you know, big good roads, and absolutely. And today we don't see, we've been provided with basic necessities.
Exactly. All of you are from Ramamurthy Nagar. In fact, we have a caller as well, a Bengaluru calling in from Ramamurthy Nagar.
Papa Malayud.
500 meters. Ramamurthy Nagar
is about 20
kilometers.
Backside.
No, so we get it. So, yes, go ahead. We have a Bengalurian over the phone line from Ramamurthy Nagar. Mr. Damodar, go ahead and tell us what is the problem in your area.
Hello.
Yes, Mr. Damodar, go ahead.
Good afternoon.
Good afternoon.
My name is Damodaran. I'm calling from Amin Nagar.
All right.
5th B Main, 8th Cross. I'm the ward number 25.
All right.
I just want to thank people for developing this area after a long time. For example, laying this drainage. So many years we have waited for the drainage to come to our area. First of all, I thank the councillor and the MLA and the ministers. Second thing is that after laying the drainage, most of the places are not been covered and it is left uncovered for a long time. For example, people like elderly people who walk on the road, they have fallen down, most of the accidents have taken place and we don't know whom to contact, how to contact those people. And for example, our councillor, Ms. Tejeshwini is there, I think, so ward number 25.
That's right.
We have not met her for a long time. I think she has to have a visit in our area at least once in a month or twice, how the development has been made. We saw her in the last time during this Ganesha Puja near our temple. After that, we have not seen her at all.
We won't
meet her, nor she has to come to our area, see that the area is developed. Some more problems are like, once we meet the area councillor here, we may try to, we are through association, and I'm one of the committee member there.
All right, Mr. Damodar. What we will do is we will pass on your number to Mrs. Tejaswini so she can get in touch with you and find out what can be done. But Mrs. Tejaswini, definitely a packed schedule after this now. You have several people calling in and telling you exactly what was. But this is the situation in Bengaluru. Your area is just one of them. Definitely one of the worst. Thank you all so much for coming out and talking to us and explaining what is the problem. Now, will we see some sort of answer is the question at this point. We spoke to several people, all of them promising different things, but we will follow up on this particular story. We will find out if action is done. With that, it's a wrap on this special, but do stay tuned. News and updates continue on the other side.